Hey, how's it going, Forum? Great to have your company once again. Since the arrest of the six Muslims in London, it seems like the plans for the false flag attack in London have been unstuck. It looks like they've changed their plans, perhaps even deviating from their original plan to fall onto Plan B. Who knows? But with this in mind, I arranged an interview with Mr. Ozboy from the OzboyFiles Institute to ask him a few questions about false flag terrorism and what's in store now that their original plans have been exposed. So I gave Mr. Ozboy a call to ask him a bit of information about what he thought about Ben Fellows, the guy who recently went undercover as Lee Hazeldine for G4S Security. Very, very interesting.
He said, and I quote, about scanning machines and that they'll be turned off during peak time. Now, come on, what does that mean? Let's test you. What does that mean? Operation Gitmo is going to go into play. So, in other words, the same as the Sari Club where somebody went in with a bag and threw it in with a bomb in it, and then all the people ran out of the Surrey Club, and then that's when they exploded the micronuke. That's what they're going to do. Now, where else did they do that? Bali 2005. They done the same. They threw a bomb under the table, it exploded. It exploded in terrorist or anything. It was all bombs under the table. That is a precursor or tells you what they've got planned for the big thing. Have people go into the stadium and that with a few backpack bombs. They're going to be letting them off in the stadium, and then people are going to be running out of the stadium in panic, and when there's enough people outside of the stadium in all of the drains, they're going to be planted micronukes, and they're just going to let them off. It's all written in code. Now unless you know about Bali, what they did for Bali the two times and how they used that, let's go on to another one, the media center. That's built on a garbage dump, all right, and it's leaking methane gas. But if you look at the logo of the security company and look at G4S, what their logo spells, it spells gas. Where did they do an operation, a proof of covert operation using a gas attack? Where? Back in 2005 at the Melbourne airport. So Melbourne airport, they did a gas attack, a proof of concept operation, and fed all the data through to MI5. In return, MI5 lent them that supergrass, who then went round in Sydney and set up them boys on them terrorism charge. See what I mean? Now, unless you know false flag terrorism and some of their terrorist attacks that they've done, you won't be able to break the code. Let's break another one. You know how the buses and the VIP cars carrying presidents and ambassadors and bloody royalty and everything like that, they're going to be fitted with remote control. Now, see what I mean? Go back to September 11th. When did they use remote control stuff? They use remote control planes there. But if you go back to the video of what they were asked to do on the last day, you know, play terrorist, and they were given guns, knives, and listen to it, IEDs. How did, what's this security company doing with IEDs? What are they doing? How did they smuggle IEDs into England to be used? So what they've got planned is to remote control, take control of the cars and buses, lead them down some bloody street where an IED will be planted in the street and boom. Where have they done similar stuff before or used a micronuke? President Harari in Lebanon. They used a micronuke on the exact same bloody pass that he was going to take. They let it off when his cars overpassed it and boom. Unless you know about false flag terrorism, what that guy wrote, nobody be able to break the code of what they've got possibly planned. Do you see what I mean? Then if you go to the velodrome, that's built on an old nuclear site. Now, I'm not quite sure on this. You'll have to ask Dimitri. Now, even if they use only a small bomb on that, a small nuclear bomb, because it's been done on a nuclear site which already is nuclear contaminated, all you need is a little bomb to go off there, and the whole thing will go off like a match. See what I mean? That's some of the stuff that I'm putting in Report 3. So I'm just going to go through all them points, go through all them facts. If I'm wrong, I'm wrong, but if I'm right, I'm right. Last thing before I hand over the mic to you, I should tell you we're 10 for 10 now, because if you go back to what he said too, here's two things. One, he said that all the people that were applying for jobs, they weren't checking references or anything like that, or anything, their backgrounds or anything. Second thing, is a lot of the people were being employed couldn't even speak English. Come in, spinner. So now let's go to the BBC. The BBC wanted to do that propaganda show in which they were going to ask all these conspiracy theorists, or if you like, researchers, investigators, onto their show, and then they were going to hack the shit out of the program and make us all look like idiots. But what they were going to do is lay the cover story. Now, everybody told the BBC to go and get stuff. So in other words, the BBC is panicking now. They can't lay the cover story out there of who to blame for a terrorist attack if it happens. We've named him Jonathan Evans, the head of MI5. I said it the other day. I mentioned it in there, and I said, if anything goes on, we'll be looking at you. Now, if you go back to the six people that were arrested yesterday or the day before, all of them can't speak English. All of them applied for a job for security at the games. They put Plan B into action because they can't get out their propaganda and lay the cover story of who to blame for a terrorist attack if it happens. What they did is put Plan B into action and went through the list. Oh, you, you'll do. Right on spot. I mean, when you look at it, we expose this. We said what's going to happen and how things are going to play out. So the first one, it's played out, and we were exactly right.
Well, I can hear where you're coming from, Mr. Ozboy. I can certainly see that letting off any kind of device over the top of a nuclear waste dump in London will certainly create a dirty bomb effect and will certainly create a contamination that will spread across London. However, I do see that what Mr. Ben Fellows, a.k.a. Lee Hazeldine, what he has come out and exposed, he's basically told us that they're not planning for the Olympic security there to be security as such, as we know it. They're planning for the G4S to actually be an evacuation squad for London. So I do concur. The arrests that happened just recently in London of the six Muslim people, I do see that as certainly having had a lot to do with the upcoming false flag attack and possibly their change in plans because they haven't had their way. I think this expose by Lee Hazeldine, by Ben Fellows, I think that has forced their hand, that they're now scrambling to get the plan back together to try and continue with some part of the operation, but not what they fully had intended. So they're scrambling to make themselves look good, like they're actually fighting terror by arresting these people. But Mr. Ozboy, please tell me, sir, if you do consider that the plan is to attack the people of London, using the preconcept of the Olympic Games being an international event that everyone will be watching, is it not possible that now that people have woken up in so many numbers? I mean, we've heard the stories from Rik Clays, some of his research, and indeed he passed on. God bless him and rest in peace. He had some amazing information. And now we've had the Ben Fellows expose, which has really blown the cover on how they plan these things and really blown the cover on the inside on how they do these things. And we've also had a recent report from Jam Noise about the gas preparations that the National Health Service of England, the UK's National Health Service, is preparing for a gas attack on people. Some amazing research there. Do check that out in the link. So do you consider, sir, that they will still go ahead with their plans? Because I don't think so. I think too much has been exposed. Too much is out there already. And it's kind of like the truthers were around before 9/11. It's kind of like we've already pinpointed the names, the people, the places, how they're doing it, and what's going to be done. I don't think they're going to do it, personally. I think too much has already been exposed. Possibly they've already mopped up part of their operations by arresting these Muslims. Mr. Ozboy, do you think they have a plan B in their sleeves? Do you think they're going to pull a rabbit out of the hat? What do you think, sir?
Okay, you have to go back and see what is the motive for all of this. And the motive is, remember, they want to kickstart the war on terror. And remember going back to 2003 when Donald Rumsfeld changed the rules for an attack on Iran. What they said was that an attack on Iran would happen after a nuclear terrorist attack would happen. So in other words, what they're saying is they're going to do a nuclear terrorist attack somewhere, Iran would get the blame for it, then they'd let off all into the media that Iran's responsible, the media would sell the story, and then the attack happens on Iran. Now, there's your first bit. There's two things at play, and I could be wrong here. Let's go back to the top of the ladder. We've got the Rothschild family, a banking family at the top, and we've got the other six Jewish families. I think, and it's only me, I can't prove it, I think it's a transfer of power. I think these three Jewish or four Jewish American families have had a meeting and they want to take control of everything. And I think they want to get rid of the Rothschild family and eliminate them and the other two families, and they take control of everything. Now, here's the other thing too. By doing that, remember I was telling you about that link? You know, the Masonic link and Illuminati link and all the rest of it. It's not really up our alley. Other people are more seeing. You know, the creation of Israel, Rothschild was behind that. Well, I reckon there's something in this, and I think the American side has had a meeting behind everybody's back, and they want to go for complete power, you know. Now, if they do, the other thing that's happening too, remember how we always say the London bankers, and so we're talking London bankers and financiers and Wall Street. I reckon Wall Street wants to get rid of the London bankers and the financiers, and then that transfer all the power over to them. Do you see what I mean? Remember the Crown, the British Cranley, they have ties in too, still to America in different ways and shapes. So I think there's another thing they want to get rid of. Now, here's the list of people that I reckon they're going to get rid of or they're after. It's only a rough list, all right? And I'll go through the list. The first person is that new French president. Remember the link you gave me about he's going to raise taxes on the rich and everything like that? Now then, after he was elected, he said one or two things too. You know, to help the poor out, and he was going to squeeze the rich people or the elite. So he's the first one on the list. And the second one I've got is the Chilean president. She's come out and she's rather left and that, so she's on the list. We've got the Paraguay president, all right, and remember that they've just invaded Paraguay, so the Americans and CIA, they're trying to overthrow them. All right, the only person on the list who looks safe, you're going to laugh at this, is Hugo Chavez. And you know why? He's the only one who could walk around them games and nobody's going to do anything to him. Because you know why? He's got cancer, so he's going to be dead within 12 months in any case. He got cancer, he went to Cuba and got the radiation therapy and the chemotherapy. So anybody who has radiation chemotherapy are dead within 12 months. So he's the only one on the list. The next one is a Brazilian president. Now remember BRICS. BRICS. Who are BRICS? BRICS is Brazil, Russia, India, China, and Spain. So BRICS. And they want to bring in a new world currency and drop the American dollar. He's on the list. The Spain president, Indian president, remember they've just brought out a new policy to bring all generic drugs to the Indian people, and they're not going to have any brand drugs. Now the big drug companies aren't going to be happy with that they're going to be feeding all these generic cheap drugs to the Indian people and no brand drugs. He's on the list. I've got the Portugal president, I've got the Malaysian president, I've got the Russian president, I've got South Africa's president, I've got the Dutch royal family. Remember, there were 7 horsemen, now there's 4, and I reckon Exxon Mobil, they want to go for top control. So if they can get rid of the Dutch royal family, remember, they control Shell. And then the last one I've got is Peru. So anyway, that's a list of people that I've done up that possibly that they're going after to try and get rid of.
Well, some of your research in the past has suggested that they're possibly going to deny entry to any Iranian officials into the Olympic Games in 2012 in London. Is this true? Is this research that you're doing, is that correct? That they're not letting any Iranian leaders to come and support their own people in the London Games in 2012? And also, why do you think that is?
You're right. Actually, done 3 things. One, they cancelled the license for Press TV, so they can't broadcast into London anymore or into England. Second one is Russia Today. They've cancelled their license. But you're right, they've knocked back his visa. The president for Iran, he's been knocked back a visa. Now, only last week, another lot of Iranian diplomats wanted to go to the games to see their people on, and they've knocked them back. Now, you can't have the patsy at the games while the terrorist attack's happening. See what I mean? So you have to have him away from the games so he can get the blame for it. So it all looks like they're trying to set Iran up as a bad guy to say that they were behind the terrorist attack or they were behind anything that goes on.
Well, Mr. Ozboy, the Ozboy Institute itself does a lot of very, very good research and does a lot of digging into false flag attacks and terrorism. In fact, it's most of the evidence that Rik Clay has pulled up, that Jam Noise has pulled up, Lee Hazeldeen, a.k.a. Ben Fellows, has pulled up, is all about what is the ultimate aim of this. I mean, even letting off some kind of gas attack or terrorist attack or micronuke, what is the ultimate aim of this? From all research that I have read, the only aim of all of this is to bring about a tighter control grid. London 2012 is in fact all about creating a new Zion in London. Is that what you see is happening, sir?
Looking at the grand chessboard, and we have to go back to the grand chessboard of power in the world and who actually holds the power, I think there's a little bit of double crossing going on and cheating and stealing, and we want to be all up the top and be the ones who are giving up all, and giving all the orders. So I reckon if this attack goes ahead, they'll use it to kickstart the war on Iran, and which is a proxy war against China and Russia. The other thing too is, you know, think about, oh yeah, create a new Zion in London. They've already created it. It's already under their control. I think what they're trying to do is steal all the power that London still has and controls in the world, and all of that power is going to be transferred over to America. Now, let's look at this. If you transfer all the power and take the Vatican and the Jesuits out of everything, and they've got troubles at the moment, the Vatican, with that Vatican fraud and all the pedophile stuff going on and all the rest of it, you get rid of the Vatican out of things, and you get rid of London out of things, that they're not giving orders anymore. All that power transfers over to America and the Wall Street banks and everybody over there. And then let's just look at the power structure then. We've got that the rat hole of a Lowry Institution in Sydney. They'll be the powerhouse for all Asia Pacific, giving the orders. We've got Israel giving all the orders for Africa and all the Middle East. We've got that new Jewish European Parliament that has just started up. They'll be the new force behind everything in Europe. And then we've got America, which will join forces with Mexico and Canada and eventually try and get all of South American countries behind them. They've got the whole power. So between the 4 areas, they've got the whole globe under their control.
Well, sir, I certainly hope that the false flag attack that has been planned, I use that in the past tense, I certainly do hope that they've now scrapped their plans. When people do their research, it seems that the powers that be freak out, and they do actually change their plans from going ahead with what they originally thought. That's because of people like yourself, Mr. Ozboy, and of course, a lot of people that are doing their research, researching into false flag events, that is making the governments start to realize that they can't mess with the truthers, because we have basically got the bases covered. We can smell their bullshit a mile away, and you can fool some people sometimes, but you can't fool all the people all the time. On behalf of the people, the listeners, and the subscribers, Mr. Ozboy, thank you very much for your time, and I'll certainly be contacting the Ozboy Institute in the future to find out more information and what you've learned and some of your research, which is really quite fascinating. Thank you very much, sir.
Okay. Thanks, Steve. Anytime.